Why is it that some people seem so motivated to exercise and eat healthy, but when we try to do it, it seems so difficult? Where do they seem to find this unlimited supply of motivation? In this video, I'm going to show you how motivation works. And if you're the type of person who struggles to find motivation to eat right and exercise, I'll show you why trying to find that motivation may actually be keeping you from reaching your goals. A little while ago, I got a great question. I want to share that question with you. And this comes from Charlene, and she says, "My biggest challenge is the desire to change bad habits, like eating too much, too many sweets, and a lack of exercise that will take the weight off. I've recently retired and find myself putting on weight without a desire to keep in shape. How and where do I get motivated?" Charlene, that's a great question, and because of your question, I wanted to touch upon motivation today. Now to start, I want to define what motivation is. When most people think of motivation, they think about an excitement or this drive to go and do something, almost like this burning desire that you really want to do it. And we see in a lot of different areas that people are trying to help others become more motivated. Think about at work, everyone's talking about how can I get my employees or my coworkers to become more motivated or to help them get motivated. Now let's touch on that just for a second, the idea of work. Now when you think about the week, what is typically the most dreaded day? It's usually Mondays, and that's because that's the start of the work week. Every Monday on my newsfeed, it's completely full of people complaining, going, "Oh, it's Monday, I don't want to go to work today. Oh, how come the weekend was so short? Oh, not another week." But then the opposite is on Friday. Everyone loves Friday because it's the last day of the work week. It's the start of their weekend. The comments on my newsfeed are completely different. It's people excited. "Oh, yes, I can't wait for the weekend. I'm excited about this." Now, thinking about this and the definition of motivation, where we talked about it being a burning drive or desire to do something, are people motivated to go to work? In my opinion, most people are not motivated to go to work. They don't go to work because of motivation, they go to work because of responsibility. These people have the responsibility to pay their mortgage or to put food on the table for their family or to take care of their family and get food and clothing and some of the basic needs. Now, don't get me wrong, some people may be extremely motivated to go to work and the money may motivate them or other aspects of their job may motivate them. But most people are not motivated by their jobs, but they still go. So I need to lay this out there right now. Motivation does not cause action, but it's actually the flip side. Action will cause motivation. Now I know this is probably not what you wanted to hear today. You probably wanted me to give you a pep talk saying, "Hey, this is how you can get motivated. Let's just get you excited to go and work out." But in all honesty, that's probably not going to happen. So how do we get into the gym and how do we eat right if we don't have the motivation? Well, today I want to give you four things you can do to help you succeed without having the motivation. Number one is to schedule your workout and treat it just like any other appointment. Now, if you're like most people, you have appointments that you have to go to, things like dentist appointments or doctor's appointments. It could be school activities, it could be classes or work. But we tend to put the most important things into our schedule, and then we do our best to make sure that we show up on time to each one of those appointments. Now, it's because we place a certain amount of importance on those appointments. What if we treated our workouts just as important as any other appointment in our schedule book? And at the beginning of the week, we wrote in exactly when we are going to the gym, and we didn't allow anything else to crowd that out. So for an example, let's say you said on Monday you're gonna go to the gym at 5:30, and then someone from work said, "Hey, can we meet at 6 o'clock for an appointment?" And you were to say to that person, "Hey, I'm sorry, but I've already got an appointment at 5:30 that I need to go to." If we treated our workouts with that same amount of priority, there's no way that we would miss a workout. Number two is to build an environment that's conducive to our goals. So think of this example for just a second. What if someone decided they had a major problem with alcohol and they could consider themselves an alcoholic? And they made the decision that they weren't going to allow alcohol to ruin their life anymore. Now, how successful would they be if they were to say to themselves, "Okay, I'm not going to drink any more alcohol, but you know what? I'm going to keep 2 cans of beer in the refrigerator just in case. Just in case I have a small craving, I'd like to have a sip or two." The thing is, this alcoholic knows that there's no way that they're going to have 1 or 2 sips. If they have 1 sip of alcohol, it's gonna turn into an entire can, and then eventually they may go buy some more. Now, what if we treated our eating a similar way? If we have a sweet tooth and we have a hard time avoiding chocolates, are we gonna be very successful if we have chocolates all throughout the house? Even if they're hidden away, but we know that they're there. The fact of the matter is, whenever you have a craving, you're going to go to that stash. And if you've got a sweet tooth and it's hard to overcome it and you have cravings all the time, then you're going to be going to that stash all the time. So how about we get rid of those things? Eliminate all of our trigger foods or foods that can become a problem and get those completely out of our house. And then on the flip side, if we want to eat healthier foods, make sure that we have healthy foods in the house. Make it as convenient as possible to be able to eat those foods. Number three is to have a strong why. Now, when I talk about having a why, what I mean is having a strong purpose, having a reason for doing the things that you're doing. When we look at wanting to lose weight or adopt a healthy lifestyle, if we look at diet and exercise and we just look at the scope of what we want to accomplish, we want to lose weight, then our desire isn't as strong to be able to do those things. But if we have a strong purpose behind losing the weight or behind doing the exercise or eating healthier, then this completely changes our approach and our focus on what we're doing. I recently read a book called Start With Why by Simon Sinek, and this book completely changed my view on things that I do and how I approach my clients. It's written as a business book, but there's a story that Simon told that had a huge, profound effect on me. And he gave the scenario, imagine yourself on a blind date. You're sitting across the table from your blind date and you say to them, hey, tell me a little about yourself. And then your date comes back with, well, I'm rich, I hang out with celebrities, I drive really fancy cars, I've got a really amazing house, I've got my own private jet, I fly all over the world, I live a pretty awesome life. When you hear that, what do you think of this person? Are they a generous person? Do they care about others? Do they care about themselves? This person seems very self-centered. What if that person started with their why instead and they shared their purpose, the purpose for what they do? And they started with something like this. I get to wake up every morning and inspire people to realize their true potential. I get to help them succeed. I get to help them realize who they are. And because I've been able to help so many people reach their goals, I am a rich man. I have made a lot of money. I'm able to drive fancy cars. I can afford my own private jet. I can afford my own nice house. But I feel so blessed because of this. Now, when you hear it that way, how does it change your perspective of that person? Are they still self-centered? Do they still seem to only care about themselves and their cars and their money? Or do they seem to care more about other people, and because of that, they've been able to do things? Now, let's put that in exercise and nutrition, and what if we approach it this way? Instead of saying, I need to eat right and exercise so that I can lose weight, we would say, I eat right and exercise so that I can play with my kids, so that I can spend time with my grandkids, so that I can move around without aches and pains, so that I can enjoy going up into the mountains and enjoying the scenery and the sights and the smells. I can help and serve other people because I'm not dragged down by being out of shape or not having the energy to help them. How would that change your approach? Now, when I work with my clients in the Body Well Coaching Program, I give them one thing to work on at a time. And one thing that I actually get to is helping them develop their why. And recently I had one client share with me her experience on developing her own personal why. And she told me that this why didn't only help her eat healthier and exercise better, but she said it also changed how she approaches her children. Her why encompassed a healthy lifestyle, but also encompassed her family, and that was the reason why she was eating healthy and exercising. So developing your why around your exercise and nutrition will give you a stronger reason to actually do it. Number four is, if you do feel motivation, then take action now. Here's the thing, you will not feel motivated most of the time, but when you do, that's gonna give you an added level of energy, you're gonna be more excited to go. So go out and do it and actually exercise or eat right, whatever you're motivated to do at the time. Now, here's what I ask you to do all the time, is to pick one thing that you can work on today. One small change you can make right now. Could it be scheduling in your workout program and treating it like any other appointment? Could it be getting rid of the junk food in your house? What small thing can you do today that will get you one step closer to your ultimate goal? Now, I'd love it if you'd go to the comment section and share with us what you're going to do. Let us know what you're going to do to make one small step towards reaching your goal. And in the comment section, I have one more thing that I'm going to give you, one more technique that you can use to be able to reach your goal. And this one actually may be the most powerful of them all. It's probably the most simple thing to do, but its effects are huge. And it's actually something that I do on a daily basis to help me reach any of my goals. Now, if you're not already at fatlossevolution.com, go ahead and go over there so you can see my comment and make your own comments. And while you're at it, share this with your friends on Facebook and Twitter. And if you haven't already signed up for my 5-day fat loss course, you're missing out. I share a ton of information in there. I'll let you know exactly what you need to do to reach your goal, but also let you know what the mistakes are that most people are making that are keeping them from reaching their goals. Thank you so much for watching this, and I hope you learned something from this. But I need your help. I need to know what questions you have. So go ahead and leave your questions in the comment section or contact me on Facebook, whatever's the easiest for you. But let me know what your questions are so that I can answer them. And remember that you have so much potential inside of you, more than either you or I can understand. And my goal is to help you achieve that potential. Thank you for watching this. This is John Gibson, and I'm out of here.